veruscawalker, and welcome to my channel. On this video, I want to share with you how I made this little chocolate mug cake. It's so cute, it would be a beautiful gift for this Christmas. It's a super easy cake to make with a very easy structure that you can interact with your cake. The possibilities, the one you can create with the same structure. You could even make a little cup of tea for Mother's Day or for somebody very special. Mugs for mom on Mother's Day or even for Christmas. You can personalize your mug and you create lots of different designs. You can put a little goodies inside. So I really hope you enjoyed this video with lots of tips and tricks for you to create this magical cake. I wanted to say a big thank you to everyone that has been supporting my channel, my website, purchasing my book and my structures. Thank you so much to everyone at home that voted for me for the Cake Decorator Network's award for novelty and children's cake. Thank you so much. It means a lot to me. It's a very important recognition and achievement in my career. So thank you so much. Let's hope that next year I can continue making beautiful videos for you and sharing with you my ideas, my crazy ideas. So for now, I just wanted to wish you all a Merry Christmas and a very Happy New Year. I see you next year. Enjoy the video. Okay, so what do you need? Basically, you need a coaster, all right? Any size. These ones from Kmart are a little bit bigger. You have this one that is a little bit bigger, and then you have these coasters that you can get on the crafty section that is a little bit smaller. And then, of course, you're gonna need a wood dowel, and the wood dowel get attached to the coaster, and then we can attach our handle too, because that's very important. And of course, you're gonna need your handles, and Bunnings have a massive range of handles that you can use, and so you can create all these different shapes of handles on your mug. Super cool. In fact, you can make a little cup of tea. There's so much things you could create in here. It's basically very similar to the idea of my beer mug from a couple of years ago. So if you wanna, you can watch that too. But we're gonna have fun decorating these cups now. Okay, so the process could not be more simple. I have a wood dowel in here, it's a 9mm thick. And I'm going to cut it at 11 centimeters only because of the size of my handle, the first hand I'm choosing, because I need to take in consideration that this wood dowel is gonna be screwed to the little board, to my little coaster, and I need exactly the space for my handle. But as you can see on the single one with the hook, I didn't have to go so high. I could have cut the wood dowel much shorter because it's a single hole. I just need exactly the distance there for my screw. So now I chose the handle I wanted to use. I mark the distance and I'm gonna pre-drill. I always make sure that my tip is exactly the same size as my screw. And this is very important because if you don't pre-drill, the wood will split, so it's very important to pre-drill everything, and then we attach our handles. As simple as that. And at this point, in fact, before you even attach the handle, I found that it's easier to protect the wood down with contact paper and then attach the handle. But you can also do this after you hot glue everything. I just found this way a little bit easier. And I also put contact paper where the screws are, another layer of contact paper where the screws are, so it protects my cakes. I also will cover my cake board, the little coaster. It's very important, so the cake is complete, protect any annoying contact with the wood or any metal. So, and then, when you have everything covered with contact paper and protect, you hot glue your handle and your wood down to your little coaster, and you have your structure. And as you can see here, I made lots of different structures with single handles, with different hooks and bolts, and I just went nuts. The ceiling hook is really cool. For our mug, I cut with the angle grinder the excess of the hook, but for a little cup of tea, as you can see, I glued the wood down right on the middle of my coaster, and I left just the way it is because I really needed the space, the long space that the hook have. But for our mug, I ended up cutting the hook with the angle grinder. But look how many designs I ended up creating. This one I just screw on the outside. I just couldn't stop. You know me, I get super excited when I'm making these videos, and my imagination just go wild and I can't stop. So now we're gonna put our cake on our structure, and it's super easy. You can choose to bake the cake already on the size and on the shape, like I did in here. I use a little tuna can, and I use that to bake some of my cakes already on the shape and on the size. But you can just get some leftovers, or get some cake, bake the cake, and just cut with your cutter to the size you need. And of course, we have to take the little space for the dowel, with just a little small cutter, you can take the little space for the dowel there, so you can start stacking your cake. This structure is really cool because you can use any type of cake, sponge cake, you can use mud cake, you can even have fresh fruit on the cake, because the structure basically is holding everything in position. You can use ganache, buttercream, anything you want. And the height too, you can go as high you want. Of course, I didn't want to go all the way to the top because I wanted to fill my mug with lots of different goodies, but it's up to you. So now it's time to make our mold, and I have already a video in here, a very popular video in fact, with many views already, of how to make your own silicone mold. I make mine with corn flour, some all-purpose silicone, 100% silicone, little bit oil and food color. It's simple as that. I mix everything together and I make a padding, and I use this padding to make mold of all the items I have. As simple as that. But if you wanted to see the video with more depth, please follow my, go to my channel, scroll down, and you will see the video with more detail. You can basically make molds of anything or everything. As long as you spray a little bit of the oil and then put on top of your molds, you can basically make molds of anything and everything. You can make stamps, impressions for your fondant. You can use all the leftover that you have to make other little decorations that you want to add to your mug. You can get brushes and jewelry boxes you have around the house. As you can see in here, I went crazy. I went around my house and I got all my belts, I got all my bags and placemats and little doormats. I just went around and started picking up everything because I see everything as a possibility. Even ribbons, I got these very thick ribbons that I really like the design. I glue on a piece of wood and I made a stamp from that. So everything is a possibility. If you open your mind and you start looking the world around you in a different way, you're gonna see that everything is a possibility. So, for cloth, sometimes if the material is too soft, what I like to do is soak the material in a mix of water and PVA glue and let it dry. So what it just does is it will give a nice firm body to my cloth so I can push against my padding, my mold, and make amazing molds from that. So now it's time to have fun. That's the part where I enjoy the most, and I have a lot of fun here because the possibilities is endless. The combination of colors is endless. And you can use the market is full of these molds now, the knitting molds and the impression mats. The market is full too. If you don't want to make yours or you don't have the time to make it, just check it out to your nearest cake shop or your websites, your favorite websites, because the market is full. And so in here I'm going to show you lots of different ways that I decorate my mugs using the molds that I bought from the internet, using molds that I made. But it's basically the same steps. We know that our mug is 11 centimeters high, and we know that the mug is 30 centimeters long. So I always open a piece of a fondant very thin on my past machine, and that is just to keep all the pieces, the loose pieces, all together, and that it will give me body to my mug too. I cut this piece of fondant at 11 centimeters high by 30 centimeters. I put a little bit of glue or water, and then I attach the pieces that I made with my mold. It's simple as that. You can select any combinations of color, and then you can attach these to your mug. So you're gonna see here on the next couple of little sections lots of different combinations that I did, and then you just hug your mug with the fondant, cut where the handle is to snuggle everything there on a space, and then decorate, fill your mug with little goodies. You can put a pickies, marshmallows, merengues, candy cane, lollies. You can put a Christmas decoration. You can use your punches to decorate the front of your mug. You can let your imagination go wild. and have some fun here. You could even involve the kids to help you with this project. As you can see, I have a lot of fun. Thank you. So I really hope you enjoyed this video with all these different designs. You could even make a beer mug for Daddy. I'm going to keep decorating my cups and putting lots of different goods in here. We can put some pigs and cinemas, some meringues. You can put some meringues. So I'm good. Cookies. I'm going to keep decorating and filling all my cups with little goodies. And I can't wait to see what you create at home. So please don't forget to hashtag me so I can see what you create at home. So I have a suggestion for you how to gift this. Just get a cake board, a little bit bigger. You can put a little bit of glue tack on the board. And then you sit your cake there so it stays in position. Get a little bit of this plastic cellophane. Otherwise, you can watch my video with the gnomes where I made these little Christmas gnomes. And I show you how to make a little box with a clear view. That's another option. But this is a super kid's idea because, you know, people can see. And there you go. A super cute gift that you can give it for Christmas.